Greetings, my name is Elijah, and in this video I intend to bring up a point that is sort of a reply-ish to Shadiversity's video series about carrying stuff on your back. So if you don't know about Shadiversity, you really should. It's a very big YouTube channel. And he talks about medieval stuff and fantasy stuff and writing, and I really like his YouTube channel. So he has recently been a very big advocate for carrying weapons on your back, and he's come up with all sorts of inventions to make carrying stuff on your back easier. He has a back scabbard, or a shabbard, that allows him to very easily carry a sword on his back. Unlike myself, I only have a backpack on me right now. It's relevant for the video. I'll get to that later. And by the way, this sword is a wooden sword I made myself. I'm gonna do some subtle flexing. It's pretty neat. I wanted to bring up a point about carrying stuff on your back, and this is something that Shad is just painfully overlooking, I think. And that is the point of horses and mules, packing animals. He brought it up very briefly in his videos about adventurers carrying backpacks for like 5 seconds, and I truly believe that horses and mules deserve much bigger recognition when it comes to adventuring and traveling in fantasy than Shad is apparently giving them. And I'm sure that Shad agrees that horses would be a terrific tool for adventuring, since it can carry all your stuff. And it can carry you as well, so you don't have to walk. It can carry more stuff than you can, plus you on its back. And it can carry your weapons as well, and you don't have to bring a lot of food for it, since it can eat off the ground. It can eat grass. So I really don't get why he is not talking about horses. Mosquito. And so maybe I should start with talking about my thoughts on his backpack video, because I'm a hiker, you could say. I have been on multiple hikes and backpacking trips, and one thing that I can say for certain is that I would not want to fight with my backpack on. And he agrees with this. I think he says that in his backpack video that it would probably be better with a horse to carry your stuff. But the point that he sort of tries to make in that video is that even with a backpack you can still carry your weapons on your back. So, as I said, I don't have a shabbard, but it would be possible to carry all your weapons, even if you have a backpack on. However, when it comes to a fight for an adventurer, suddenly there's monsters and you have to fight them off. And you can get out your weapon quickly because you have a very good shabbard. But then you have a big heavy load on your back that you don't have time to take off. It takes some time to get a backpack off, and then it lays on the ground and it can be stolen. So yeah, one thing I can very confidently tell you is, with a proper hiking backpack, I would not want to fight people. And I think it's a little bit harder than Shad actually wants to say, because for one, in his video, he is carrying a very small backpack, and he acknowledges that it is very small. The backpack he was wearing is probably for one night hike at max, because you need to bring a lot of stuff if you're going to do multiple nights. And if for an adventurer who goes on long journeys, they would definitely have something bigger like this. And this one isn't even very stuffed. If it's fully stuffed, it would be a lot higher up like this. And yeah, it would be significantly bigger. And so when it comes to swings and strikes with a sword or an axe or using a bow, the backpack would be a big hindrance. So that's another point why you would want a horse. And I think that a lot of fantasy settings do the right thing and have horses. For example, Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, and my favorite book series, Ranger's Apprentice, where the rangers basically have relationships with their horses, and that can be another interesting thing, where the adventurer's horse becomes a vital part to the story. If they lose it, it's bad, it's a problem for them, and they can be sort of like another character in the book or in the story. So yeah, swings would be not very good, I think. Just imagining a big backpack on my back, I would not want to fight off monsters with a sword. However, I think there is one weapon that would be optimal for an adventurer that carries a backpack. And so let's say you have an adventurer who can't afford a horse. He doesn't have a horse. His only means of traveling is with his own feet, his own legs, and he has to wear a backpack because he's going on long journeys and has to sleep in the woods multiple nights. Then I would say that the best weapon for such an adventurer would be something approximating a spear. This one is pathetically short, but imagine about twice this length maybe. And a spear can function as a walking stick, which is a thing that a lot of hikers like to have if the terrain is difficult, and which it would be if you are on your own two feet. If you're sitting on a horseback, you don't really have to worry about the ground unless it's really dangerous for the horse. But with your own legs and difficult terrain, a walking stick is a very good tool to have, because you can brace yourself on it, you can hold your balance, and it's a tool that can be used all the time, and it doesn't really add any weight to you because you can hold it in your hand. And the other thing about spears that would make them optimal for backpack carriers is that the main attack that a spear does is thrusts, which doesn't need any big swings that the backpack would be hindering. So I think an attack like this, attacking with a spear, fending off enemies, would be actually quite easily, even with a heavy backpack, because you kind of aim with one hand and you thrust with the other. And this motion, it's almost completely unhindered by having a big cumbersome backpack. When, in comparison, a sword would in some cases get hindered by a backpack. For example, if the backpack extends a bit higher, which a lot of proper hiking backpacks do, then it would actually be possible that the sword would hit your backpack if you're swinging over your head. So the two things I want to bring up with this video, the a discussion is, one, Shad, please give more love to horses in adventure settings. I really think you should make a video about why horses are good, because they are excellent for adventurers if they can afford them, because they can eat almost everywhere. You don't have to bring food for them. They can carry you, so you don't have to walk, and they can carry your weapons and your luggage. And the other thing is that the best weapon for an adventurer on foot with a heavy backpack would be a spear, since thrusts with a long spear doesn't need a lot of swinging, which would be hindered by the backpack. So Shad, I hope you see this video. It would be very nice to get some recognition. You're one of my favorite YouTubers, and yeah, I would be very happy if you made some sort of reply video, or just making a video where you acknowledge how good horses are for adventurers. And yeah, if you watching are new to my channel, I do very random stuff. I do just what I feel like when I feel like it. It has no schedule, no theme. It's just what I like to do at the moment. And if you like that sort of channel, then go ahead and subscribe. If you want more routine channels, then you don't have to. But you can at least click the like button down there, I think it would be, or there. And yeah, thanks for watching. I am going on an adventure!